started to build our own labs to grow plants, to learn more about plants. Also, now I have a team of people from biology, horticulture. So this was very important because we needed to know a lot of plants. So we grow a lot of type of crops, and also we test a lot of techniques like hydroponics, aeroponics, etc. So after 2 million euros of investment, we built these three products. So here is the control system, cool farming control. Here we have the cool farm eye, and there are the instar. I'm going to talk more about it. So this is the control system. It's an intelligent control system. So we brought to the agriculture scene for greenhouses and warehouses, the machine learning and the artificial intelligence part. So in this computer, you can plug and play all the sensors and the actuators that you need, and the cool farm will give you all the data. But it does more. So we built this very intuitive interface, so everything is very intuitive. This is very important for the new growers, for the people that are working in urban farming, because you know systems like Priva, Ugendorn, and Ortimax are very complex, and they don't know how to deal with all the data and all the complexity of the system. So, and we did it for all the devices like iPhone, Android, all the laptops, etc. So here we can see data. We can see all the farms at once. I can have a farm in Portugal, another one in China. Everything is integrated. The system is very flexible. I can see also the warning, so everything in my pocket. So this is other cool feature. This is the recipes part. So here the grower has the power to control everything and set up their own recipes. Okay, so he can set up all the parameters for the air, the light, the water cycles, everything. And cool farm, what's cool farm? Cool farm goal is like, you know, this is like Google Maps. So the grower wants to reach a certain point, and cool farm will tell him how to do it in the best way. And this is the cool farm eye. So it's an optical sensor. It doesn't take pictures or films. It works with MDVI, so it captures the plant greenness and the plant growth. In the end, the plant health. And this is very important for growers because it can minimize the errors. The growers can really understand what is going on with their crops. And finally, our latest product, it's the Cool Farm Instar. So it's an automatic machine, a vertical one, to grow local and fresh food all year round. So this is our target here, are the growers, of course. This is very good for germination, for example. But our main target are the retail, okay? The supermarkets, hotels, restaurants, because in retail they have a lot of transportation costs because they buy the food outside the city in greenhouses. And then they have 40% of waste, so this is very good for them. So we also are solving here a lot of vertical farming problems, like the control system, the interface, the intuitive interface, the lifts for easy management of trays, and the clean room. So the operator or the grower doesn't need to get inside the machine, okay? Everything is automated. So we also have these boxes. So this is a plastic box. It has a substrate with the seeds inside. So the operator just need to put the box inside the machine, the plant will grow, and it will be ready for sale in the supermarket. So after the construction of our labs, we also did agreements with several clients. This is our test site in London. This is an aquaponics site. This is a greenhouse that we have in Portugal, growing flowers. So, and now, is EdTech a good area for startups? You know, startups is all about technology. So, and yes, the answer is yes, because, you know, it's trendy. Now everyone wants to be in this area. It's very sexy. And also it has good numbers for investors. On the other hand, it's very, very difficult. It's very hard to get traction in the market. So there are no unicorns in this area. Why? Because, you know, people, a lot of people that don't know nothing about plants, you know, in startups is like that. So we need to grow, we need to understand the plan. Also, you need to know very well the market, all the stakeholders, the suppliers, the clients, everyone. And also you need to be flexible because things change very fast. And regarding the machine learning, LED, everything is starting now, so you need to be prepared for that. Also, you need a smart money, and your investor needs to be prepared for failures because you will fail a lot. We have 3 years in the market and we are still failing now. So, because you know, this is not doing one more app, one more Instagram. This is, we are creating critical software for living beings. So here, there is a quotation from Kurt. He's the CEO of the AgTech VC firm, and he's saying like that, you know, it will take another 5 years to have a big company in this area, a big startup. Yeah, so regarding numbers, the numbers are good. So last year, they closed 580 deals, so 3 billion is invested. And it's growing 60% per year, so it's good. And the top priority are robotics, big data, as you know, and analytics. So what I have learned, this is a market that you need to work as a team. It's where plant science meets robotics and marketing, a lot of marketing and also creativity. You need to find new ways to grow food. Also, this is a good example today. What you are doing, it's teamwork. So to finish, we have clients worldwide today. We are selling a lot. So we have clients in Europe, Singapore, and USA. And we have partnerships with all these guys. Osram, they are the biggest one now in LEDs, Vertical Farming Association, and IBM. And one important thing is the university. So we work a lot with people from the universities. So that's it. Questions, please.
Thank you, Igor. As you nicely respected the time, there's ample time for questions. So, who has some questions for Igor?
I was wondering, the system, do you sell that as a service or as a product?
We sell the aim control, it's a one-time sell. So we sell the computer. Also, we can sell the actuators and the sensors. We have partnerships to do that. But yeah, you need to pay a monthly fee. So it's also a service for the cloud.
And the sensors and aggregators, how do they communicate? What kind of protocol?
This is Ethernet. We are using Ethernet, yeah. But we have also other, like, you know, older one, but the Ethernet is the best now. And it's very flexible, because this is a robot, this is a computer, so. It's like, it is different from Priva, you know, and Ortimax and Ganon. They are using automatons, PLCs, so this is a completely different, yeah. You know that.
Okay, other questions?
Very quick one. How did you find your investors?
Oh, this is, you know, we don't have a VC, so we started this with our own money. We are 5 founders. One of the founders, it's our own money. And we got 1 million from the European fund, yeah.
But you have collaborators like the Washington Post, et cetera. What is their role?
Oh, that's just, you know, that's about the news. We were in the news.
Hi.
Hello.
What is your vision on the kind of products that you are will be able to produce for a price that is economically viable in the market, and for which markets? What is your vision on that?
Okay, so you know this kind of products that we are talking about in indoor farming and vertical farming, the growers and even the in-store, we only grow microgreens, you know, aromatic herbs and the mixed salads. So. That's the kind of crops. It doesn't make sense to grow, you know, big plants inside. It's not our field.
And the markets, are these niche markets?
Yeah, regarding the InStar product, the turnkey solution, we are selling now for supermarkets, you know, big retailers like Group, Metro Group, you know. So they want to grow local food. It's very important for them, and now that even in terms of marketing, it's very good to bring people. You know, it's very good to say that the food is fresh, it's there, so it's different to buy food from outside the city. Regarding the growers, we are only tackling the indoor farming and the urban farming. We are not in. We have some greenhouses, but it's not. We are not competing with Prika or. No, it's not our thing.
Yeah, I'm working Ralf de Vries from the Greenhouse Research Center for Vegetables. My concern with these systems is the energy consumption. So I would like to have an idea of you, what would be the energy consumption per unit, and in terms of durability, is it feasible or not?
You know, the energy is, it's a problem, you are right, and it's regarding the LEDs, you know. So I don't have the numbers here, but I know that is the main problem, it's the LEDs, and you know, that's not our concern. You know, we work with Osram very close. They are doing a special LED for this machine, the InStar. So let's see, but yeah, the energy, it's a very important thing. But you know, regarding the comparing this product with warehouses and even greenhouses, you know, it's very good. The OPEX, the CAPEX, we have good numbers. And if for example, retail, the payback, if they buy a machine to grow microgreens like, you know, basil, for example, they will pay the machine in 1 year. So the payback will be 1 year. Lettuce is 5 years. Of course, it depends on the market in the country, of course, but the numbers are good, yeah.
Okay, any other questions? If I would use your system, we enter into an agreement. Is ownership of data part of the agreement?
Yeah, you know, the grower, he has the ownership of the data. But you know, I think that there are two kinds of data, you know, because you know, Google Maps learns with all the data, so my system learns with all the data, of course. But the owners, they have their own recipes, you know, to grow their crops, you know. So I think there is, you know, this is kind of tricky. In the contract, yeah, they own the data, okay? But my system learns with that, you know? But I'm not seeing the reports, the analytics, I don't care, but the system is learning because the machine learning works like that.
So you might know which recipe is most successful, comparing among different clients.
I can do that, yeah, but it's not legal for me to do that, to see the recipes, because, you know, the growers, they want to put more flavor here, there. It's their brand, you know. It's their product. I don't really care about that.
Is there then a community of your clients, mm-hmm. where they interchange know-how and experience?
Yeah, you know, the thing is here is maybe we have two type of growers, because we greenhouses, you know, the oldest growers, they are not very open to this. So you know, we work with young growers. You know, they are not people from plants. You know, they now know how to grow plants, but they are guys like. Curious guys, you know, that they want to do something about sustainability, growing food inside cities, or they are very concerned with health, you know. So they are open. They really don't. I don't think they care about, you know, sharing data. That's not hard. But in greenhouses, yeah, in the Netherlands, yeah, I know that. So, but it's different. It's different markets. Okay.
Would a major market in the Netherlands be marijuana?
No, I don't think so. In the United States, yeah. Yeah, in the United States, for sure.
Okay, after this last inspiring question, I suggest we close. So, thank you.
But he, wow. He's true. Thank you.
That brings us to the next speaker of this session. This is